Appreciate you guys coming. I want to thank you guys for coming this morning. Wow, this is incredibly humbling. To you students, it's been a hard week, really hard week. Even though TMP administration still refuses to give me an answer as to why I'm not being invited back next year, your being here this morning has redefined why I've spent 33 years teaching and coaching at this place, a place I affectionately call The Rock. You guys know I love teaching the classics. They're classics for a reason. They contain universal truths that that transcend time. And they connect us to all of mankind, and they remind us that we're not alone. Every one of you, well, not all of you, but most of you will recall reading To Kill a Mockingbird. My man Atticus Finch in there tries to impress upon his young daughter Scout that courage is not just getting back up after you've been down. Instead, he says that courage, real courage, is knowing you're beat before you start, but you rise up, try your best, and see it through to the end. A handful of you have been in my Advanced English 3 class, and we read the novel recently, One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest. In that novel, my man R.P. McMurphy, he could escape the insane asylum anytime he wanted. But he chooses to hang back and see it through to the bitter end because his inmate cronies, they need him so desperately. And then there's my man right over here. Where is he? St. Thomas More? Oh, there we go. He like looks like one of you guys. Anyway, one of my favorite quotes of all time comes from the play about him, entitled A Man for All Seasons. And that quote is, well, let's just say it captures this day perfectly. I'd like to read it to you. If we lived in a state where virtue was profitable, common sense would make us good, and we'd live like animals and angels in the happy land that needs no heroes. But since, in fact, we see that avarice, pride, lust, and stupidity commonly profit far beyond humility, chastity, justice, and thought, and we have to choose to be human at all, perhaps we must stand fast a little, even at the risk of being heroes. Today, you guys are the heroes. You're the heroes. You've chosen to stand up for something way bigger than yourselves. For truth, for justice, for critical thinking. I think every man on earth is given a cross that he has to bear. Apparently, this is mine. But I'm certain that I can make it through the next 2 months because you guys are going to be my Simon of Cyrene, helping me carry my cross. Today, you are my heroes. You're my heroes. Lastly, this really isn't, you know, in the whole scheme of God's plan, this setback is, it's little. I refuse to let it define me. And I don't want it to define the rest of you guys' school year. We've got a lot of learning to do yet. A lot of research to do. There are a lot of contests and competitions to be won. And besides, we got to get back to the system, baby. The system. Come on now. The system, baby. The system. One more time. The system, baby. The system. That's what I like to hear. Again, you know, we're going to go about our work, you know, symbolically via the system. And so I just want to thank you for coming this morning. And I would like to, as you guys go into school today, I'd like to have you come right past here, and I would like to acknowledge you individually. Once again, thank you for coming. Your support has been overwhelming. And regardless of how all this shakes down, I will never forget that. Thank you.